alarmed with what's happening in privacy in America and the invasive tactics of the NSA. And well, yeah, the problem with Obamacare, and this is just from a technological standpoint, Alex, is that there is absolutely no security at all. For example, I can create a website, claim to be an agent, and ask, you know, let you log on, and because it's a healthcare system, I can ask you the most intimate questions, and you're going to answer them online. I will then get your social security number, your birth date, all the information I need to assume your identity and empty your bank accounts the following day. And yet, there is nothing in this central system that I can go to verify that this is a legitimate website. It's insane. It is insane beyond belief. And I don't know who thought this thing up, but they have to be a complete idiot. I know that it is the most insecure thing for Americans now. If you're signing up for Obamacare, you have no idea if it's a legitimate website. And I can tell you now, the cost to the consumers, to the American public, in terms of identity theft and their bank accounts being wiped out, is going to be many times the entire cost of the Obamacare program. This is insane.
What is the best form of internet security?
You know, common sense is number one, okay? For example, let's use Obamacare. If you're going to be signing up at all, make sure that it's a legitimate site. Number two, never, ever give out information that's private to you, even if your own bank calls you and you're sure that it's the same bank. Well, wait a minute, that should be on file with you already. Why are you calling me? So you just never speak it, you never write it, you never give it to anybody. And if someone's asking you for it, what the hell are they asking you for? Excuse my language. Why are they asking you? This is the problem. You know, we are so gullible, some of us, that we go, well, okay, it's the government, it must be safe. Or, you know, it's my bank calling me, it must be okay. Well, it's very seldom safe. Never give out anything about yourself. Not your home address. Not the name of your wife. Not the name of your parents. Not where you were born. Nothing. And if people ask for it, be suspicious. Be really suspicious. But now, the government is actually one of the hackers, in my mind. I mean, they're wanting inside your head. They're wanting to know your intentions. They want to know who you with, who your friends are, why you're friends with them. Something is seriously wrong here. Privacy, in my mind, is one of our unique and inalienable rights. The right to privacy we have lost as American citizens. Remember 1984, there were actually safe parts of the world where there was no government spying. Well, that's not the case in this case. No matter where you are, you can be seen, watched, and heard.
But then if I try to go to the NSA or my reporters do just to ask questions at the front gate, they flip out and act like we're terrorists.
Well, also, you're probably going to get audited.
Well, I mean, it just shows they want all their privacy from us, but we have no privacy.
Absolutely. That's the government, what it's doing, and you become an enemy. Yet you try to keep the government from knowing what you do, then you become the enemy as well. It's like insane. There's no hope in the system until we regain some inalienable rights that are in our Constitution. And we need a privacy to protect ourselves. And so, of course, well, anything that we build which is positive is going to be used by the criminal elements of society. We can't stop it. They use telephones. They use cars to get away from bank robberies. What do? We take cars away from people? So this is insane. To use this rationale for, don't let McAfee build that product because this is dangerous. It's going to let crooks get away with things. Well, it's also going to let me be private and you be private and all of us be private. So what do? Do we sacrifice our privacy for the illusion of safety? There can't be safety without privacy, Alex. Well, you know, first of all, the reason that many people are indifferent is because it's easy to be indifferent. It's easy not to know what's going on, not to know what party the president is in. Because if you don't know, it can't scare you.
That's what my dad said last night.
If you don't know, then you can imagine anything that you want and pretend that that's true. That's what's happened here, and that's what this world has become. We don't want to know many times, because if we know, we have to do something. We don't want to do anything, because doing something is scary. I think that's the fundamental problem. Without privacy, we have no individuality. We become a machine. I don't want that. You don't want that. And ultimately, the world will look at itself and say, wait a minute, we have gone crazy here, and things will change.
Yeah, for those that don't know, sociologists, anthropologists, psychologists, historians all have found one element that is the most important for freedom and creativity, and that's privacy. Privacy, they don't even fully understand it, but if you don't have privacy, you're a slave. It's a very simple equation. Why is that, John? John McAfee, why? Why do we have to have privacy? Why is it so important?
Because without privacy, sir, because we're humans and because we are imperfect, we get judged. All right, why do we do certain things in privacy? Well, because, you know, we know that what we're doing here might offend somebody's sensibility somewhere else. What we're doing here, someone may not want us to do because of, who knows what, competition, greed, all of the things that humans have. Privacy is our protection against ourselves. All humans have the same thing. We are all, to some extent, greedy. We're all, to some extent, jealous. We are all, to some extent, lustful and all of the other things. And given that fact, privacy is our protection against ourselves. When we can go and do things which really are innocent without people becoming afraid of what we might be doing. And so we all have to have it. It's the necessity of life if we are to be individuals. Now, if we're in some communist state where we all think alike and dress alike and there is no change, well, you don't need privacy. But then there are no people as well. We are robots. The question is, do we have the courage to remain human? I don't know.